In this video, we're going to finish out the Proving Lines Parallel worksheet, and this is a free worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Geometry tab. Our directions for numbers 11 through 16 are to find that value of x that makes lines u and v parallel. So in number 11, we can see that the two angles we're given information for are alternate interior angles. And if they are alternate interior angles, that means that if both u and v are indeed parallel, then those alternate interior angles will be equal in measure. So if those angles are equal in measure, then u and v will be parallel. So that means that 16x minus 6 needs to equal this right angle, which is 90 degrees. So let's add 6 to both sides of our equation, and in doing so, we'll get that 16x is equal to 96. When we divide both sides by 16 in order to isolate the x, we get that x is equal to 96 divided by 16, which is 6. So 6 is equal to x in number 11. In number 12, we can see that the angles we're given information for are corresponding angles. That's because they're on the same side of the transversal and they are on the same side of the intersected lines. They are both below the intersected lines. And if the intersected lines are parallel, then corresponding angles are congruent. So in order for u and v to be parallel, 12x minus 4 must equal 10x plus 10. So now let's solve for x. I'm going to start by adding 4 to both sides to get that 12x is equal to 10x plus 14. My next step will be to subtract 10x from both sides. That'll leave me with 12x minus 10x, which is 2x, and that's going to be equal to a positive 14. And finally, when I divide both sides by 2, I'll get that 14 divided by 2 is 7. 7 is equal to x in number 12. And number 13, my angles are alternate exterior angles. And just like alternate interior angles, in order for my intersected lines, u and v, to be parallel, my alternate exterior angles must be congruent. And congruent angles have the same measure. So x plus 112 must equal 105. When I subtract 112 from both sides, I get that x is equal to negative 7. So negative 7 is my solution in number 13. In number 14, again, I have alternate exterior angles because they are on opposite sides of the transversal and they are both outside of the intersected lines. And we know that in order for my intersected lines to be parallel, those must be congruent. So 19x minus 4 is going to be equal to 110. Adding 4 to both sides, I'll have 19x equal to 114. And dividing 114 by 19 and 19 by 19, I'll get that x times 1, which is x, is equal to 114 divided by 19, which is 6. So 6 is my solution in number 14. In number 14, you can see that the angles I'm given information on are corresponding angles because they are on the same side of the transversal and they are on the same side of the intersected lines. They're both to the right of those intersected lines. And in order for my intersected lines to be parallel, we know that those two corresponding angles must be congruent. So 11x minus 2 must equal 130 degrees in order for u and v to be parallel. Adding 2 to both sides, I get that 11x equals 132. Dividing both sides by 11, x is going to be equal to 12. And lastly, for this set of directions, number 16. My angles are alternate interior angles since they are both inside of the intersected lines and on opposite sides of the transversal. And if we want u and v to be parallel, we know that 7x plus 14 must equal 8x plus 6. I'll start by subtracting 7x from both sides to get that 14 equals 1x, or x, plus 6. Next step, I'll subtract by 6, and we know that 14 minus 6 is equal to 8. So 8 equals x for number 16. Number 17 and 18 are my critical thinking questions. In number 17, it says, for question number 16, find a value of x that makes lines u and v intersect. Well, in number 16, the x that we found, this 8, makes u and v parallel, so they will never intersect. So any number but 8 will make these lines intersect. For example, let's just pretend x is 0. If x is 0, then 7 times 0 is 0, and 8 times 0 is 0. So one angle is going to be 14 degrees, and the other angle will be 6 degrees. So my transversal would be here, and 14 degrees would look something like this. And again, this is a rough estimate. So here would be 14 degrees. And then if I had 6 degrees going this way, that would be something like this. So you can see that that line will eventually intersect. So really, any number besides 8 will make lines u and v intersect. Now let's look at number 18. Even if the lines in question number 16 were not parallel, could x equal 25? Why or why not? So let's go up to number 16 and see if it can. Let's plug in 25 for x. If we plug in 25 for x, we'll get that 7 times 25 plus 14, which will equal 189 degrees. So now this angle is 189 degrees. And for this angle, 8 times x will be 8 times 25. And if we're adding 6 to 8 times 25, 8 times 25 equals 200 plus 6. That would make this angle equal 206 degrees. So we have 189 degrees and 206 degrees. So our answer in number 18, even if the lines in question number 16 were not parallel, could x equal 25? And that is a no. That would make the angles 189 degrees and 206 degrees, which are both greater than straight angles. So if we have our transversal, in order to get an angle that's 189 degrees, pretending this is the intersecting point, 189 degrees would go past 180 by 9 degrees, so roughly here. And you could see if we were to draw that intersecting line, we would really come up with two smaller angles. We would come up with this angle of 9 degrees, that angle of 9 degrees, and my other two angles of 171 degrees, being this angle and this angle. Therefore, 189 degrees and an even greater angle, 206 degrees, would not be possible. And as always, don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and comment below.